Welcome to the statics tutorials. For this problem, we have a mass 100 kilograms that's supported by this cable system. So the mass is supported with cable EA. A is a knot, and then we have from the knot out to a wall at B. Then we have from the knot out to a wall at D, and then we have from the knot out to the ceiling at C. With these particles in equilibrium, we're always going to start off by drawing a free body diagram. We want to look for the one point where everything connects together. So for this problem, that's going to be point A. We'll draw the weight that acts on point A, so that's our 100 kilogram mass times 9.81 meters per second, the acceleration due to gravity, to give us a 981 Newton force acting down on A. Then we have the force in cable A to B, so here FAB, the force in cable A to D, so here FAD, and the force in cable AC, FAC. We do know the direction of AB. It's going just in the negative x direction, so we already have direction information for AB. We already have direction information for FAD. It's going in the negative y direction. We have some distances here for the displacement from A to C, but we're going to have to somehow use that to calculate the direction of FAC. We'll start by writing a vector for that displacement. So this is R, since this is a displacement or position vector, it starts at A and goes to C. So in X, you can see there's a 10-meter distance. This 10 meters, the line that has the 10 meters on it with the arrows is parallel to the x-axis. That's how we can tell it's our x displacement. And if we're starting here at A and we're going to C, we're going out in the positive x direction. So positive 10 meters I. Over here, we have 5 meters. We can see that this is parallel to the y-axis. So this is going to be our y displacement. And if we're starting at A and going to C, we're going out in this positive y direction, so plus 5j. And then in the z direction, we're going from the plane, xy plane here, up to point C, and that's this 12 meters. And you can see this is parallel to the z-axis, so plus 12k meters. This position vector has the right direction, but it has the wrong magnitude for a force vector. So we need to find its magnitude, this total length of the cable A to C. We can do this by taking the 10 meters squared plus the 5 meters squared plus the 12 meters squared, adding it all together, taking a square root. We get that the length of the cable is 16.40 meters. Now we can develop our force vector. So our force vector is going to be its correct magnitude, which is an unknown still, but we can just add in magnitude of FAC times our position vector, RAC, divided by the magnitude of our position vector, RAC. This RAC vector divided by the magnitude of RAC turns this into a unit vector. That's why when we multiply it by the force, it now becomes our force vector with the same magnitude as the force. To do the calculation, take each component, so we take 10 and then divide by the magnitude. So it would be 10 divided by 16.40, and that would sit in front of your I here. Then you take your 5 divided by 16.40, that would be your y component, and sit in front of the j here. And then your 12 divided by 16.40, and that would be your z component, and sit in front of the k there. And this is actually the unit vector that defines that direction multiplied by that magnitude FAC. Now we can do our sum of forces. So we'll start in sum of forces in z. We'll get that the weight is 981 newtons. It's acting in the negative z direction. There's no z component of FAD, and there's no z component of FAB, so they don't show up in the equation. We do need to get the z component, though, for FAC. So we'll come here and we'll grab what's in front of K, and then we'll do this, 0.7317, what was in front of K, times FAC. Those two added together have to equal zero, since this is in equilibrium. We now have one linear equation with one unknown, FAC, and we can solve for FAC. We get 1341 newtons. and then rounding off to three significant figures, and then also converting to kilonewtons because the number's larger than 1,000, we get 1.34 kilonewtons for FAC. Then we can do sum of forces in the x direction. There's no x component here. Looking at FAB, though, FAB goes in the negative x direction, so we'll write a negative FAB. There's no x component of FAD, so it's not in the equation. And then we'll take the x component of FAC. So again, we'll grab what sits in front of the I here, so 0.6098 times our FAC. We already know what FAC is, so we can go ahead and plug it in. The only thing that we don't know in this equation is FAB. We can solve for FAB. We get FAB is 818 newtons. Then we can do our sum of forces in the Y. With sum of forces in the Y, the only two terms that we have are this negative FAD, because it goes in the negative Y direction, and then the Y component of FAC. So this is going to be negative FAD times the 0.3049 that's out in front of the Y here, times the magnitude of FAC, the 1341 newtons, and we can solve for FAD, and we get the 409. Thanks for watching.